Steve Diamond was found dead at his home about a week after taking a lie detector test on the Jeremy Kyle show. The programme was permanently axed as a result of the incident, and it prompted an inquiry, with MPs now considering stricter regulations on how contestants are treated on air. A former participant told the committee about his experience on the programme and how it had a negative impact on his life.
No one really ever sat me down and said, Dwayne, you're going to go on television, millions of people are going to see you, you're going to be labelled the most hated, people are going to hate you in your town centre, in your workplace, you know. No one really says to me, Dwayne, this is what's going to happen to your life.
One reality show that has also come under scrutiny is ITV's Love Island. Two former contestants took their own lives after taking part in the show, but their deaths have not been linked to it directly. However, it did prompt calls to look at the aftercare that's received. Former Islanders Marcel Somerville and Ywande Byala defended the support they got.
You know, they said, you know, how would you handle fame? Do you think you can handle it? You know, how would you handle trolling? Do you think you'd be able to reach out? How would you reach out and stuff like that? And I felt like I was fully prepared.
I'm Chris, I'm 27, and I'm a club promoter from Newcastle.
Former fellow Love Islander Chris Williamson also knows what sudden fame feels like, but says it's people on social media that need to act more responsibly.
Viewers seem to think that because someone's been on reality TV, they're just fair game to throw abuse at and tweet things that you'd never tweet, even to your worst enemy.
In a statement, ITV said it takes its responsibilities around duty of care to participants very seriously. The inquiry continues. Angela Barnes, 5 News.